So I think blacklisting is a primarily secret way that organisations restrict who they wish to employ, and the principal thing's about secret. So you go through an interview process, you apply for a job, the idea about what the job is set out clearly, you ask questions, they ask questions, the reasons for getting or not getting a job are pretty open. Blacklisting is the secret side. That's the bit where you don't know why you were refused employment. You don't know why your contract was suddenly terminated. Blacklisting is a way that organisations have a set of criteria they don't reveal to the general workforce that says we don't like people with these certain conditions, beliefs, attitudes, and we're not going to either employ them or continue to employ them. So you expect to see their name, date of birth, national insurance number, career history, sure. Pictures of them on picket lines, letters they've written to newspapers, gossip about them from colleagues, graffiti on toilet walls, petitions they may have signed, legitimate union activity they've taken place in, union positions they've been elected to hold. So engaging in normal democratic procedures is enough.
Grew up in Bristol, went to the local schools, fell out of school, fell into local factory, which was Rolls-Royce for me. And I stood to be the sectional shop steward after a few years. This was in the early 80s. I was probably in my late 20s. After a series of difficult years with Rolls-Royce, and then an occupation of the plant to protect the jobs of two fitters that were up for the sack, and we were successful. After 3 days, the fitters were reinstated. Some 6 weeks later, I was summarily dismissed, trumped up charges using anti-union laws brought in by Thatcher, but I was actually dismissed under a Labour government using the same anti-union laws, which was taking part in illegal industrial action.
So there are 3,213 people on the files. We don't have copies of all their files for various kind of reason. We've got a lot. We've seen a lot. We've seen more than most people from the book. This is one I'm looking at. It's got date of birth, address, national insurance number, member of UKAT London region, organised petition with UKAT over homelessness. Okay, so this chap is a bricklayer /labourer /hod carrier. Organised petition with UKAT, which is the building trade union, over homelessness. What's that got to do with his hod carrying job? Described as bad news in quotes.
Because if you're on the blacklist, you don't get work. And if you don't get work, you could lose your house. If you lose your house, your family could fall to pieces. If your family falls to pieces, you can throw yourself under a bus. That's not a dramatised thing. That's what happens. Workers have committed suicide for that chain of events. So when these people do this thing, employers pay for this service, the service is carried out, and people's lives are then laid to ruin. The consequence is as dramatic as a loss of life. I think these people should be had up for manslaughter, they should be had up for breaking the law, and they should serve a sentence. Anyone who knows about it but does nothing about it is culpable. That's MPs, that's trade union officials.
It's interesting looking at the map. There's concentration of, simply going by postcode, concentration London, which is about northwest quite a lot, Scotland quite a lot as well. But actually, pretty much every county is covered. I mean, the postcodes are, Isle of Man. I mean, they cover the full length and breadth of the country. There are about 25 names from Bristol. Kind of further link in terms of evidence given by Colin McAlpine, who's one of the directors of Sir Robert McAlpine Limited. So when the Consulting Association was first set up in 93, it needed some seed money. Colin McAlpine, who's based in the Southwest, offices over in Aztec West, he paid £10,000 to kind of set the organisation up. McAlpine's paid 10 grand to kind of buy, if you like, these kind of files, kind of set itself up on its own. Capline's also paid incurs fine for breaching the Data Protection Act, although they didn't tell anybody at the time. They paid £5,000 as a way of kind of doing right, I suppose, by their former employee. Colin McAlpine has a lives up in South Gloucestershire, looks after the South West, and was intimately involved with the Consulting Association throughout its period. Its last chairman was a HR officer from McAlpine's. McAlpine's have been very closely involved from the beginning throughout. Colin McAlpine in particular, who is a member of the Merchant Venturers Stalwart of Society locally, and has appeared before MPs to answer questions about why they've been using TCM, why they've been involved so closely, blacklisting on the Olympics, blacklisting on the Millennium, a number of allegations put to him. And he raised himself that the contract they had for Cabot Circus, they'd used the Consulting Association as well for that.
I know it was them that kept the file. I know it was employers who paid for their services. I know that. I know it was the government of all persuasions that closed their eyes to it. I know that. But I also know that senior trade unionists had collaborated.
We've also got files on this chap who's a teacher in London, living involved in the construction industry. His file talks about him going to attend an anti-fascist demonstration. Okay. And then we know that he was being monitored by Special Branch because we spoke to the Special Branch officer involved. We've got various other people who were in the construction industry who we spoke to Special Branch officers who wrote files on these people. And we have information that's on their blacklist files that appears to replicate what was on or repeat information that was only held on their Special Branch files. Information about their activities that would never have been known by the construction industry.
And it's a deliberate act by employers to stop people they perceive as troublemakers who are simply going about a business of making a workplace a fairer, safer, more equitable workplace where collectively you're obviously better off. And it's that collectivity that they want to break. It's any individual protest they want to squash, and so that they get a very subservient workforce.
There is a systemic problem. This 44 companies subscribed at one time or another to Consulting Association. Thousands of kind of checks carried out over a number of years. This isn't the kind of bad apple thing. You know, the whole barrel has a problem. But I still think there is a systemic attitude problem about respecting people's democratic rights to organise and express themselves and how that works in the kind of workplace. I don't think that's been resolved, and I think it carries on. I think that it's been explicit in things like the North Sea oil industry. It's been exposed in the construction industry. We've seen people involved in the blacklisting generally go on and profit. The number of people sacked over this is, I think, zero. Okay, number of workers affected, thousands. Those people who have been named and shown to have been primarily involved have gone on and been promoted. They've gone on, gone to work for other major organisations. It doesn't seem to have affected their kind of career. So I do think it requires another look about the way employee relations operate, because it seems to be that those implicated have not necessarily suffered, and those who are the victims are only really just kind of getting to the beginning of a process of getting any kind of compensation.